Do you already own a Fabric capacity and you have already used Azure Logic Apps to run your capacity during working hours from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. and pause it afterwards from 4 p.m. to 8 a.m. in the morning? And you have already built your Logic Apps workflow to run your capacity during working hours from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. and pause your capacity from 4 p.m. to 8 a.m. in the morning and keeping your capacity in suspend mode during the weekends, but you are after even more flexibility, like pausing your capacity during Christmas period and resume it afterwards? If that sounds like a scenario that you are pondering about, it is exactly what we are going to find out in this video. Hi, I'm Soil Bakshi, a Microsoft Data Platform MVP, with a very warm welcome from biinsight.com. If you haven't watched my two previous videos about the topic of managing your Fabric capacity costs using Azure Logic Apps to pause and resume the capacity, I would encourage you to watch those videos because they are prerequisites to this video. In this video, I am going to expand the previous solution that I built in the second episode of this series. And for that specific reason, you would need to follow the previous videos if you haven't done so far. In this video, we are specifically building upon the previous solution that we have done in the second episode of this series to cover the Christmas period. In Christmas period, no one is working, so why my Fabric capacity should incur any costs for me? I use workflow definition language to write an expression to identify the Christmas period for where I live, which is New Zealand. You can modify it to work for your own scenario. So let's begin. While this expression may look a little bit daunting at the beginning, but what it does is pretty simple. It determines whether a current date in New Zealand daytime zone falls within a specific range, which is from 25th of December to the 2nd of January. Let's have a look at this part of the code from a closer view. I get the current year based on the UTC date and time, and then concatenate it with 25th of December, and then I get the integer value of the results. The code does almost the same thing to determine the 2nd of January of next year. It gets the year part of UTC now, it turns it into integer and adds 1 year to the year part, then it concatenates it with 2nd of January, and the next part of the code gets the current date and time based on New Zealand time zone and compares it with the 25th of December to determine if it is greater than or equal to the 25th of December current year. The next part of the expression works almost the same as the first part, where we get current date and time in New Zealand time zone and compare it with the 2nd of January of next year. Now let's copy the entire expression and go back to our Logic App solution to continue the implementation. Let's head to Azure Portal using portal.azure.com. If you have used Logic App recently, you can see it on the screen, so you can select it. Otherwise, you can search for Azure Logic Apps on the search bar and select the Logic Apps option. Now I select the previous Logic App solution that I was working on. Let's click on the pause resume Fabric capacity. And from here, I click edit. This is the solution that we built in our previous video, so I just open it. Now I need to add just one more condition. And to do that, I just click on the plus button and click add an action. Now again, I add a new condition and rename it to check if the date is in the Christmas period. From here, I use the expression that we have discussed earlier and I click add. The results should be equal to true. I want the workflow to work normally if it is not during the Christmas period, so I just need to move the entire condition of my previous implementation into the false condition. The next step is to add a condition while we are in the Christmas period, so I can leverage the work that I've done before. I just copy this condition and I paste it into the true part of the Christmas period condition. I paste the action over here And now I just need to rename this into condition check if the status is paused for the Christmas period. So I just add that in. We want to check if the status of the capacity is active during the Christmas period, then we pause the capacity. So I select the invoke resource operation and I change the action name to suspend. And I also rename it to suspend during Christmas. We are all set now, and this is how the entire solution looks like. So this is ensuring that our capacity is paused during Christmas. Let me just save the solution. That is pretty much it. In this video series, we have looked at the possibility of pausing and resuming our Fabric capacity using Azure Logic Apps, and also to keep the capacity paused during the Christmas period. I am using this method for a couple of months now, 6-7 months. In the next video, I will share with you some of the costs associated with running my Logic Apps during the past couple of months, and also the savings that I've made by running these Logic Apps solutions. Some of you may prefer to use Azure Functions or any other methods. They will work all the same. So my choice was to go with Azure Logic Apps, but your choice is your choice, and you can select whatever solution that you are more comfortable with. You perhaps can use the APIs and run them in PowerShell, which cost you perhaps nothing. But my choice was to use Logic Apps, and I'm actually very happy with my choice because I'm also learning along the way. So what is your choice? Have you done this before? Have you followed these series of videos? Share your thoughts in the comment section below. I hope you have learned something new in this series. Thank you ever so much for watching, and see you in the next one.